Hi, my name's Richard Chambry. This is Rich Photo Books. It's my photo vlog series that I host on YouTube, all about my photo book collection that I've been collecting over the years and new photo books that I've been purchasing recently, hopefully giving a little bit of inspiration to new photographers out there who want to look into what the great photographers do and their work in practice, and also photographers out there who might have missed a few books along the way. Today's book that I'm featuring is David Bailey Locations. It's the 1970s archive. I'm a child of the 70s. This was hugely interesting to me because of all the fashions and what people look like and what it reminded me of out there. David Bailey, on his many travels, when he's been abroad photographing people in models and shoots, always gravitated to try and find the local photographer, and this is one of them. So, you know, a great example of, you know, he's not just out traveling about the world, photographing the beautiful women and doing the, you know, the models and great locations. What he did was he got out there for a reason. He got out there to do the job, and then, I think these are his words, just to take the piss a little bit and travel on and go and shoot his own project. So he could be in some really exotic location and he'll go and photograph the people and the landscape. And, you know, he was a very well-rounded photographer. He could photograph many situations. And I think probably because of his East London background and his upbringing, he was able to relate to people on a real good level and could really get stuck in. I'll just flick you through. As you can see, it's a huge book, so I do apologise. I am trying to hold it with one hand kind of thing, but I just want to flick through to a few examples of this. This is in New Guinea, where he was shooting some portraits of some local tribespeople, and I really love that. He's obviously got his kit and all the rest of it, but it's just the way what I really like about David Bailey is that he just completely throws the kitchen sink at every photo situation. He will be using any camera, any type of film, flash, no flash. He'll just experiment continually, and you really notice that with his photography. It's not just like this complete theme to his photography where everything is black and white or everything is very high gloss and the rest of it. It changes all the time. He's a great chameleon in a way. He's a way of photographing people, as you can see here. Hold on, I'll just get that up. You know, he's really managed to get in touch with the people there. He can really, you know, he hasn't got to bother with talking to people, asking them if he can take their photograph. Look at these are amazing. You see, these are in colour now. So, you know, it's giving you a great example of what David Bailey is about. He's not just a bit of a personality on the telly or personality in the photographic world. He's a real craftsman. He really knows what he's doing. Amazing, lovely street photography as well. This is in Goa in 1974. So let's just have a bit of a flick through, because I just want to be able to show you this Mother Teresa. So he'll go from shooting some social bit of street photography. That's at the Notting Hill Carnival. And then he's got a great portrait of Malcolm McDowell. So he's continually flicking between the, you know, two ends, you know, street photography, his portraits, his high end fashion. You can see here, this is Marie Helvin on the stairs, and that is in Tahiti. Then he's got some pictures here, like of Andy Warhol, who he's hanging out with, obviously. And so, yeah, if you're starting out, I mean, this is a great book for that, actually. If you're starting out, that's a good example, because he's That's really like high quality black and white studio photography. Quintin Crisp in 1978. If you're starting out, I mean, this is a great resource, this book on its own, just to really see how he's photographing things, how he's positioning the models, the style. I mean, you see this a lot now, this style, this high contrast style of colour photography. You see that in a lot of magazines. And, you know, he was doing that back in 1976. In fact, I've seen quite a bit of that style as well. Like, maybe he got it off Norman Parkinson a little bit. Norman Parkinson got it off him. These are all obviously all my thoughts. I'm not being weird about knowing what they were up to, but a guess by looking at the books and the years and the rest of it. You know, they're like a musician will take bits from, you know, other bands. I think like David Bowie and the Stones were always nicking bits off of each other, and the Beatles and so on. So the same goes for the photographers of the time. This is in Haiti in 1976. Yeah, and he's out photographing. Oh yeah, famously photographed the Vietnamese refugees, 1979. That is. So, as I said, David Bailey is a legend. But you know, there's a reason why he's a legend, and it's primarily because he just knows what he's doing, and he can interact with people. And you know, that's half the battle. That is really half the battle. So. Highly recommend this book. I'll put all the links underneath. You can go and get it yourself. Go and get someone to purchase it for you. It's quite heavy, big coffee table book. And I hope you like it. Please do leave some comments underneath this video. Give me some recommendations. If you'd like to follow me, I'm on social media at RICHFOTO, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, bit of Snapchat. Hit me up on there. Give me some recommendations. And go and have a look at the other vlogs on the playlist on YouTube, and I hope you like them. Thanks ever so much for watching again.